Okay then, welcome you all for the fifth floriculture session regarding the one more important cut flower with respect to the domestic market and the international market, that is gladiolus. This gladiolus is very popular. This is a bulbous flowering plant. You have to remember this. This is a bulbous flowering plant. This is commercially exploited for the cut flower, both in domestic and international market. It is introduced to India in 16th century. This is ideally grown for the bedding and for the exhibition purpose. Then this is also used for the flower arrangement, bouquet, and indoor decoration. With respect to the botany, this is also called as sward lily, Gladiolus grandis. Belongs to family Iridaceae. It's a weed actually. It's a weed in European country. It's a weed in the maize. This is also a definite question. Gladiolus is a weed in the maize. Then the basic chromosome number is 15. Then Pliny Elder. He is the guy who described and named the gladiolus. Gladius means sword. It resembles like a sword. The leaf will resemble like a sword. Then first time this gladiolus brought into cultivation from its natural habit, that is South Africa. Initially it was recognized as weed. Then it is believed that Greece is the first country who cultivated this crop. Then coming to the varieties, we can find different range of color groups here. For example, pink, green, this is a pink variant, and this is the green variant, and red, white, brown, these are all the red variants. This is white variant. Here also tinting is done in the gladiolus also. Then purple and violets. This is the purple and violet colored gladiolus. Then yellow, rosy color. These are all the different color range observed in the gladiolus. There is no need to remember all those varieties. Then some of the important cultivars suited for the Indian condition. The important cultivars like Snow Princess. This is commercially grown in India. Then Suchitra, you have to remember this. Suchitra is a light pink colored variety of gladiolus. Then Rose Supreme. Then some of the other varieties like Mayur. You have to remember this. Mayur, White Prosperity, Pink Friendship. These are all the important ones. Then with respect to the climatic requirement, it is well grown in the 10 to 25 degree temperature. Then excessive average temperature in the combination with the light deficient period may result in the flower aversion, flower desiccation. If the temperature is excess, the flower will desiccate. If the temperature comes less than 10 degree, the plant growth and development will be arrested. So the optimum temperature will be 10 to 25 degrees Celsius. Then this require full exposure. This is mainly cultivated in the open house, open land cultivation. Then this is quantitatively long day plant. This is qualitatively long day plant. This has to be remembered you. The long day treatments delay the flowering, but improves the bloom quality. Hence it is called qualitative long day plant. The long day condition of 12 to 14 hours photoperiodism increases the number of florets, spike length, and flowering percentage. You remember gladiolus belongs to qualitatively long day plant. Then with respect to the soil, yes, well grown, good drainage, sandy loamy soil is best. Sandy loamy is most preferred with a pH of neutral. But this is sensitive to salt and pollution. You have to remember this. The pollution is most adverse factor with respect to the cultivation of gladiolus. the fluoride injury is common in gladioli. Hence, the polluted atmosphere, we can't grow gladiolus. Then with respect to the propagation, it is commonly propagated through vegetative means, that is corms. With respect to seeds, this is only followed with respect to breeding purpose. These are all the corms. Corm is the commercially exploited method of propagation in gladioli. According to the American Gladioli Council, they have categorized the three group of corm size. Here is this: large size, medium size, small size. There is no need to remember all those things, but you remember under large size, the jumbo is the special type of grade which comes in gladioli. More than 5 centimeter of diameter of corm is called jumbo type. Then with respect to the micropropagation, this is not yet commercialized in gladiolus because corms is very abundant. Then land preparation, manure, fertilizer application, these are all common things. Usually the planting is done on the beds or on the ridges, the planting method followed. With respect to spacing, 30 into 20 centimeter. With respect to irrigation, at weekly intervals. Then some of the important cultural operations like weed control. Weed control is a major problem in gladioli because if the weed is dominated in the field, the gladioli crop is suppressed. Hence, the weed control is also major one. Mechanical method that includes the removal of weeds through plowing, hoeing, that is hand weeding. This is done at least a month or 2 month interval. Then the chemical method of weed control is very important. You remember diuron, then alachlor, metachlor, oxofluran. These are all very important chemical weedicide used in the gladiolus. Then mulching is also very beneficial to improve the plant growth and also weed control. The organic and inorganic, both types of mulches are used, like straw, coconut fiber. These are all locally available one. But mulching is not generally practiced in cultivation. With respect to staking, this has to be remembered. Staking is followed in gladiolus to support the plants. These are very tender and susceptible for lodging. Hence, we have to go for staking. The butterfly and the miniature types, this has to be staked. Then with respect to the growth regulators, this is also very important. The treatment of corms with the ethrel at 100 ppm, which enhances the sprout, which enhances the sprouting of corms. Then the 20 ppm BA, benzyl adenine, which enhances the sprouting of corms, which will break the corm dormancy. Then foliar spray of NEA, 1000 milligram per liter, it's also which inhibits the sprouting. Why you need to inhibit the sprouting at the growing stage? Once it reaches the maturity, it will start flowering. But beside the bigger corms, mother corms, the smaller corms will arise. So we have to inhibit the sprouting. We have to reduce the photosynthesis to flow into the smaller bulbs. We have to concentrate on flowering. At that time, this has to be followed. Then application of CCC at 0.8% soil drenching increases the spike length, number of florets, and slightly advances the anthesis. This is important. Cyclosil. Then coming to the harvesting. When to harvest? For the local market, when to harvest, the basal florets are fully open. When the basal florets are fully open, then we have to go for harvesting. for the cut the top leaf sheath with the help of sharp knife. Then the cut spikes were immersed in the bucket containing the water. Then coming to the harvesting of corms, it generally takes 6 to 8 weeks after the harvesting of spikes for the corms to become mature and ready to lift. Then these corms were lifted and stored in the earthen mudds. In India, generally the lifting of corms is carried out manually with a small garden forks or kurpees. With respect to the post-harvest management, the Society of American Florists, this has given the grades like fancy, special, standard, and utility. The Society of American Florists given the grades in the gladiolus. Then this is the standard size of corrugated fiber box. Usually 10 to 12 bunches of gladiolus is packed for the export. Usually the pre-cooled at 4 to 5%, 5 degree Celsius. This is the pre-cooling temperature. You have to note it down. 4 to 5% 5 degree Celsius. For the corm storage, this is also the storage of corms at the low temperature is established at the commercial scale. Why to store the corms? Because this temperature will help the break of dormancy. Then it will helps to overcome the warm and dry condition in the summer months. So it will also prevent the premature sprouting of corms. Hence, we have to store the corms after the harvest in 4 to 5 degrees Celsius. Coming to the yield, per hectare, we can expect 2 to 3 lakh cut flowers per hectare. Then coming to the physiological disorder, this is very important. You have to note it down. Tip burn means this is due to high level of aerial fluorides. The fluorides present in the air, this will cause the tip burn. You remember, tip burn in gladiolus is due to fluoride, toxicity of fluoride. Hence, we have to avoid the growing of gladioli in the polluted air. How to control this spray? Blightax. Then geotropic bending. This is also very important. The tip of the gladiolus spike show tendency to bend against the gravity. It will grow upward. If we keep the gladiolus cut flowers while storage are in the pre-cooling condition, it will grow away from the gravity. Hence, the tips will be curled. This condition is called as geotropic bending. This is primarily due to the downward movement of auxins like IAA. And this IAA will accumulate in the lower portion of the spike. Hence, the spike will grow upward. This IAA causes the asymmetrical elongation of cells in this region. So, the tips will grow upward. Hence, the bending will be observed in the spike tips. This bending of tip doesn't affect the vase life, but it will reduce the market value. Hence, we have to take care while transporting. How to control this? The tips of the spike should be clipped off to show the bending. To prevent the bending of the tips, the spike should be held vertically while storage as well as the transportation. We have to keep the cut flowers in vertical position while in the transportation or in the storage house. This is the measure to control the geotropic bending. You remember, geotropic bending is associated with the physiological disorder of gladiolus. This is very important. With respect to the disease, the fungal disease is major problem is Fusarium wilt. How to control this? Use fungicides like carbendazim and mancozeb. Then storage rot. This is also very important. Dry neck or neck rot. Then botrytis blight or flower rot. Then leaf spot. Then bacterial leaf spot is also very important. One of the precautionary measure is the corm should be dipped in the mercury chloride before planting and storage. Then coming to the insect pest, the aphids, thrips, and the sucking pests are one of the major problem. Then borers also problematic. Loopers and semi loopers also problems. Then this is also called as corn flag. Another name of this mainly called in Europe. Sward lily. This is also another name. This is a gladiolus is a Latin word. You have to remember gladiolus is a Latin word means sward. Who gave the name? Pliny Elder. Then the basic chromosome number is 15. These are all the different groups under gladiolus. Grandiflorum, primulus, then butterflies, miniature, face up. These are the different types. No need to remember all those things. This is the grandiflorus. This is primulus. This is highly exploited for cut flower. These are all butterfly type. These are for decorative types. Then this is the miniature, mainly for potted plants. You remember, miniatures are for potted plants. These are also for the bed purpose, decorative types, face ups. Then these are the some of the good cultivars. You remember in the white color, the lipstick will be the important variety. Then this powdery puff is also very important one. American beauty, this is also important one. As I said, this is a qualitative long day plant. For the early flowering, we have to give the long day condition. Lengthening of the day with artificial light in the winter months increases the Yes, Srishti, Ankita, Anuj, where did it disconnected? At which slide it was disconnected?
Sir, your slide isn't visible now, sir.
Sir, slide is not visible.
Wait. Now? Now visible, right?
Now visible, sir.
Yes, at which slide it was disconnected? Classification.
Classification, yes, sir.
Yes, at classification it was disconnected, right? These are all the important. These you can consider this as different ecotypes or different species or different classes in the gladiolus. This grandiflorum, you remember this grandiflorum is mainly for cut flower production. Then this primula is also important for cut flower production. This is commercially exploited in gladiolus. You are listening, right? The voice on the screen is visible. Voice is audible correctly?
Yes, sir.
Then this butterfly type is mainly used for the decorative types. Used as the flower beds. You remember butterflies types are used for the decorative type. Then this miniature are mainly used for the potted plants. Then this face ups also used for the to decorate the garden. Then the important cultivars. With respect to important cultivar, this lipstick is majorly asked in the JRF. You remember lipstick belongs to gladiolus crop. Then this powdery puff is also frequently asked. American beauty. These are all the important. These are all the important varieties. Then with respect to the flowering. One sec. Yes, with respect to the photoperiodism, environmental condition, this is qualitative long day plant. If we want early flowering means we have to give the photoperiodism more than 12 hours. To lengthening the day, if we lengthen the day with the artificial light during the winter hours, it will increases the flower production. If we decrease the photoperiodism it will directly affect the flowering percentage. Hence, it is called as qualitative long day plant. Audible, right?
Yes, sir, you're audible.
Yes, yes. Then with respect to the light intensity. With respect to light intensity, it is mainly a long day plant. If you given the photo period is more than 12 hours, it is very essential and it will promote the very good flowering. With respect to the propagation, sexually by seed for the breeding purpose, asexually by combs and carmels. These are all the baby combs of this comb. These are all mother combs also used for the commercial cultivation. These are all, this vegetative propagation, this comes under combs and carmels. These are all the combs of gladiolus used for the commercial cultivation. This is the mother comb. Under this, the small combs will appear. This is a mainly monocot. You remember gladiolus is a monocot. A monocot plant, it contains the fibrous root. This is the mother comb. This is the offset or carmel. These small are carmels. The gladiolus crop will looks like this. Comb with root, fibrous roots. Usually before planting, the carmels were dipped in the 1% or 0.1% benomil solution to avoid the soil-borne pathogens or fungus. If you given the proper moisture and the environment for the combs, the swelling of the combs and the roots will be appeared in the lab condition or the cold storage condition also. These are all the initial sprouts. You see the leaves looks like sward. Here, the hilling is also very important. Hilling means it's also called as earthing up. This is an important cultural operation followed in the gladiolus. You remember that staking is also very important. Fluoride injury occurs in gladiolus. You remember like this. After the harvesting, curing is done. You all know with this terminology, curing. Curing is also comes in onion and garlic. You remember the gladiolus combs also associated with the curing. I'll see if any important points are missed. I'll just spell out. These are also other classification. We have different types of classifications. There is no need of in-depth here. You just remember these are all the different classification of gladiolus. These are all the different species of gladiolus. This is for your reference. Now, these are all not important with respect to the exam point of view. This is only for your kind information. We have around 220 species in gladiolus. These are all the different species. this grade is also important, given by Society of American Florists. Then with respect to the flower biology, with respect to flower biology, I will tell you, the petals and the sepals are fused. Hence, the terminology used is here, tepals. Tepals are 6 in number. Tepals also observed in orchids. You remember, tepals also observed in orchid and gladioli. Then, this is protoandrus. Proto, here the male part will matures first. Protoandrus type. Then this is one more, the stigma is, what is the speciality of the stigma here in the gladiolus? The stigma is divided into three surface. What is the terminology? We have a specific word for that. You just write it down. You have to tell me in the next class. What is the special botanical term used to call the stigmatic surface of gladioli? Then with respect to the flowering, acropetal means the flowers will open from the downwards to upward. This is very important. Acropetal succession. Basipetal means from the top, the flower will matures first. Tricarpillary pistil. Tricarpillary pistil is found in the gladioli. That is forked stigma. Three forked stigma or leathery like stigma. You have to remember this. This is the answer for that. Then I have told you, Fusarium and Botrytis rot is very important in gladioli. These are all the major disease. With respect to the methods of breeding, usually we introduce, then we go for the selection. Here in the IHR, the hybridization work is major, and also the regional fruit research station at Shimla, HP. They also developed many variety, and mutational breeding is also very important. In the mutational breeding, the gladioli, many hybrids has been evolved. At the IRI New Delhi, there are about 7 varieties has been released. You have to remember this. Apple Blossom, Snow Princess, Sensation. These are all very important. Snow Princess, then Sensation, Apple Blossom. These are all very important one. Then Lady Killer, this is also important. Red Kenna, Oscar, this is important. With respect to IHR varieties, Beauty Spot, Cherry Blossom, Friendship, then Melody, Watermelon Pink, Wild Rose. These are all important varieties of gladiolus developed from IHR Bangalore. With respect to the hybrids from the IHR Bangalore, we have Meera, Nazrana, Poonam, Sapna, Aarati, Apsara. These are all the important hybrids. Remember these hybrids from IHR. There is no necessary to remember all the crosses. You remember the important hybrids evolved from IHR and IRI. Arka series, then Agnireka, Mayuri, Pusa, Suhagini, Suchitra. These are all very important for. And with respect to NBRI variety also, these are all the 22 hybrids. Archana, Basant Bahar, Gazar, Indrani, Hans. These are all the important hybrids. From the Chaubati also, they have been released, but not that much important. With respect to the mutational breeding, I have told you, this is very important in gladioli. Salmon sensation, Arachnaeus butterfly, Shobha. These are all the important spontaneous mutants in gladioli. And for the induced mutation, you remember the physical mutagens and the chemical mutagens used for the mutation work. This yellow Picardy, this is also very important one. Then for the chemical mutagens at IHR Bangalore, we have released 4 varieties. Beauty Spot, Melody, these are all the 2 important ones. Generally asked in the MCQ type questions. Then breeding for the disease resistant, I have told Fusarium and Botrytis are very important. And breeding for the fragrance is also very important in the gladiolus with respect to the commercial cut flower scents. These are all incense, new era, frilled fragrance. These are all the hybrids, fragrant hybrids. You remember that one. Botanical approach, micropropagation is not that much commercialized, but this has been attempted at the research level. In vitro mutagenesis. You remember mutation is very important in gladioli. In vitro mutagenesis has been exploited at the research level for the evolution of new variants in gladioli. I feel this much is enough for the gladioli crop. If you have any doubts, you can ask now.
Sir,
yes.
Can I please ask a question?
Yes,
sir. Sir, so the butterfly type of gladiolus is used for decorative flower, but you set out the important points of those things. Will that be necessary for exam point of view?
One sec. I think battery is going to die now. That's it. Yes, tell me your question now.
Sir, at the beginning, you explain the different types of gladiolus along with their uses. For example, butter type of gladiolus, they are mainly used for decorative flower bed. Sir, you mentioned the important uses, will that be important for exam point of view? New questions used to come out.
Yes.
Okay, thank you.
I mean, with respect to the explanation, according side by side, I have to tell you some of the important questions, which are all necessary with respect to the JRF point, right?
Yes, sir.
Yes, okay, sure. Then I ask the question now, who coined the word gladioli? Pliny Elder, I have repeated thrice now. Okay. Which is the commercial method of propagation in gladioli?
Corms and cormels.
Yes, exactly. If the corms and cormels, both options were given in the MCQ, you go for the corms. Then which are all the different methods to break the dormancy in the gladioli crop? This is very important with respect to the objective types and assertion and reasoning type questions. The low temperature storage for 2 to 3 months at 4 to 7 degrees Celsius, which will break the dormancy. Then ethylene chlorohydrin, this will also break the dormancy. Then before planting, we have to treat the corms with thiourea 500 ppm. Then GA3 at 50 ppm. This will also break the dormancy. Then BA at 50 ppm. This will also decreases the dormancy. Okay. Low temperature, ethylene chlorohydrin, thiourea, GA, BA, benzyl adenine. Okay. Then any other doubts? Then with respect to the cultural operations, which are all the important one? Earthing up, then hoeing, staking. Then sometimes the string or the rope is also tied for the plant to avoid the lodging. Okay. And with respect to the weed management, I have told you hand weeding is efficient, but pre-emergents like atrazine, oxyfluorazine, these are also commercially used. Then you remember pre-emergent like atrazine and oxyfluorine. Then for the, these are all pre-emergent. And also stomp is also pendimethalin, that is pendimethalin. Stomp is a commercial product name. Pendimethalin is a chemical name. Then with respect to important diseases, the Fusarium oxysporum, that is Fusarium wilt. Then botrytis. Botrytis is also called as gray mold or blue mold. This is very important. With respect to important pest, thrips, aphid, these are all the common sucking pest, and also leaf eating caterpillar like Helicorpa, these are also important one. With respect to disorders in the gladioli, you have to remember, one is negative geotropism, then leaf tip, what is that? Fluorite toxicity, what we call that? For the fluoride toxicity, the tip will burn. Second disorder. Then third disorder is topple or bud rot. This is due to calcium deficiency. You remember topple or bud rot. This is due to calcium deficiency. And blindness means we will not observe the flower. This is mainly due to unfavorable climatic condition. Blindness, topple and bud rot, negative geotropism and tip burn. These are all the four important disorders in the gladioli. You remember like that. You have to remember the bullet points. Okay. Then any other doubts or anything to add for the gladioli? If you know any important sir, points, you can also join. Yes.
Somehow I'll get this what to study about cut flowers, loose flowers. Within your four classes, I get an idea, sir. How far we should cover this landscaping and all, sir?
With respect to landscaping, I will cover in detail because so many species are there, so many potted plants, then yes, succulents, cacti, climbers, trees, annuals, biennials. There are n number of things are there. We'll discuss in one class. Okay.
Okay, sir.
I'll tell
Thank you
how to read all those things.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Okay. Then the fluoride toxicity will cause the tip burn. This mainly occurs where the polluted atmosphere will be there. And with respect to tip burn, this is also caused due to super phosphate or rock phosphate. If we apply the fertilizers through foliar, if you apply the super phosphate, it will cause the toxicity in the leaf. So it will burn. This is also associated problem. Then the scoring is very common in gladioli. You remember scoring. Scoring means, what is scoring? Anyone know? You can answer. If it is wrong also, we'll see in the next class. What is scoring? Scoring in gladioli. Yes, this is the assignment for you guys. What do you mean by scoring in gladioli? You have to tell me in the next class. Okay. If I ask the questions, if I only answer the questions, you won't read with respect to floriculture. That's why this will be your assignment for the next class. Srishti, you have to remember me tomorrow to ask this question.
Sure, sir.
Ankita, euphoria. This is okay with respect to gladiolus?
Yes, sir.
Okay, then we can end the class now. Okay.